tell us, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الْمَلَأِ مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى إِذْ قَالُوا لِنَبِيٍّ لَهُمْ أُبْعَثْ لَنَا مَلِكًا نُقَاتِلْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ قَالَ هَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِنْ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ أَلَّا تُقَاتِلُوا قَالُوا وَمَا لَنَا أَلَّا نُقَاتِلَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَقَدْ أُخْرِجْنَا مِنْ دِيَارِنَا وَأَبْنَائِنَا فَلَمَّا كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقِتَالُ تَوَلَّوْا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِّنْهُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ It starts with verse 246. Allah says, do you recall when a prophet after Musa alayhi salam? Who is this prophet? According to the Mufassirun, this is Samuel alayhi salam, a prophet from Bani Israel. And they said to their prophets, send us a king that will fight for the sake of Allah, and we will fight behind him. Bani Israel had gone through a transition at this point where they had power, they oppressed, and now they were oppressed and powerless. And they still have prophets amongst them, and they still have some righteous amongst them. And they say to their prophets, send for us a king. Ask Allah to send us a king so that we can take back, we can reclaim our place of power and position in this world. Nuqatil fi sabilillah. They said we will fight for the sake of Allah. But subhanAllah, there's a clue in this ayah. There's a clue in this verse. When Samuel alayhi salam responds and says, how do I know that you're going to be sincere in that? They did not respond with their love of Allah. They respond with, what do we have to lose? We've already been driven out of our homes. We've already been humiliated. And that's the wrong answer right away, because the motivations should not be worldly. So they just said, Nuqatil fi sabilillah, we'll fight in the way of God. But they're saying, we've been humiliated, we have nothing to lose anyway, we might as well give this a shot and we might as well go forward. We are not a people who turn to Allah only because we have nothing else to turn to. We are a people who turn to Allah when we have everything and when we have nothing, because we realize that everything stems from God. Everything good comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a king amongst them, they turned away except for a few amongst them. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ نَبِيُّهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ بَعَثَ لَكُمْ طَالُوتَ مَلِكًا The Prophet responded to them and said, Allah has chosen Talut, a righteous man amongst you, to be your king. How did they respond? أَنَّ يَكُونُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ عَلَيْنَا وَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ بِالْمُلْكِ مِنْهُمْ وَلَمْ يُؤْتَ سَاعَةً مِنَ الْمَالِ They said, wait a minute, Talut. Who is Talut? Talut is not a person of wealth or status. Talut is a person, the scholars mentioned, from the tribe of Benjamin, alayhi salam. He was from the weaker tribes, the lesser tribes. And they'd been so accustomed to having new standards of wealth and power that they said, wait a minute, we want someone who's royal, someone who's noble to lead us. So why should he lead us when he's poor? They mentioned his poverty. Also a wrong answer. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respond? إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاهُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَزَادَهُ بَسْطَةً فِي الْعِلْمِ وَالْجِسْمِ Allah chose him amongst you and increased him in knowledge and بالجسم, in his physical body, in his physical strength. What is this talking about? العلم, Allah mentions that knowledge is what gives a person superiority, especially or only if it manifests in taqwa, in piety. And so this is praiseworthy knowledge which manifested itself in piety. Talut was a righteous man, a knowledgeable man. And Allah gave him al-jism, which literally means, by the way, he was the tallest man amongst them and the strongest man amongst them. Goliath, who was the oppressor on the other side, Goliath was a huge man. And they said, Talut, being the tallest amongst Bani Israel, he would not come to the shoulder of Jalut, of Goliath. He's a monstrous human being, a huge man, powerful oppressor. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds and says he's been chosen for his piety, his knowledge, as well as his physical strength, and you need to follow him. Allah gives his dominion to whom he wants. What did they respond with? Can you send us a sign? Give us an ayah. Allah gives them a sign. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the tabut, which was basically a box that had some of the belongings of Musa alayhi salam and Harun alayhi salam that the people used to find blessing from, barakah from. And it was taken from them by their enemies as Bani Israel was in a difficult situation at this point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it back from the enemies and the angels placed it right at their doorstep. That is a sign that Allah is the one who is going to give you victory or keep you in defeat. Follow your leader. Follow that king. And so Talut goes forward and they follow Talut. First test comes. They get to a river and they are not allowed to drink from that river, though they are very thirsty. Remember we talked last week about the connection between sabr and steadfastness, patience and fasting and courage, holding yourself back. They're very thirsty and a test comes to them from Allah. Don't drink from the river right now. Hold yourself back. And what does that do? It expels the real ones from the fake ones. And so that 80,000 dwindles into 4,000 graduates, 4,000 men. And then through another period of testing, they become 313. What does that number sound like? Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma said, the same number of the people of Badr. Subhanallah. So the righteous amongst them are always very few. They're always qaleel. In every generation, subhanAllah, the righteous are qaleel. They're few. But through that few, great things happen. And so Talut roots out all of the rest of them. Remember what Allah would tell the Prophet ﷺ about the hypocrites in Tabuk that claim to be Muslim? But they just caused they just brought a demoralizing effect to the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet ﷺ, it's better that they don't go out with you. It's better to have a small group of people that are dedicated to Allah, that are righteous, than to have people that are back and forth and swinging between righteousness and falsehood. And so now Talut goes forward and he has the same number of the people of Badr amongst him to take on this massive army. Amongst his soldiers was Dawood alayhi salam. And Dawood alayhi salam was not a huge person physically. He wasn't yet declared to be a prophet. He was just one of the righteous men of Bani Israel. And Dawood alayhi salam, as Talut calls out and says, who's going to fight Jalut? Dawood alayhi salam says, I will do it. What does he have? He has a slingshot. He has a stone. Subhanallah, if there is any image that comes to your mind, think about that iconic image of Faris Uda standing in front of a tank with his stone, not fearing that tank in front of him. Dawood alayhi salam is not afraid of Goliath. He's not afraid of Jalut. What can you do with that stone? What can you do with that slingshot? Bi-idhnillah, by the permission of Allah, I can do a lot with it. And he comes forth to fight Jalut. And this was before the battle started. Just like every other battle, you have the three that come out from each side, or the one or the two. The duel that takes place before the battle. Dawood alayhi salam comes out. And Dawood alayhi salam is victorious against Jalut from the very beginning. وَلَمَّا بَرَزُوا لِجَالُوتَ وَجُنُودِهِ قَالُوا رَبَّنَا أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah says, this righteous group of people, as they came forth, what did they do? They made dua. They said, oh Allah, pour upon us patience. What type of patience are they talking about? Are they talking about the patience with, you know, their desires? Are they talking about the patience with hardship? Or are they talking about courage and steadfastness? I want you to connect to last week's khutbah. The courage and steadfastness to continue. رَبَّنَا أَفْرِغْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا. Pour it upon us. وَثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا. Plant our feet firmly and grant us victory over a disbelieving army. And Dawood alayhi salam overcomes Jalut. فَهَزَمُوهُمْ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَقَتَلَ دَاوُودُ جَالُوتُ وَآتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَعَلَّمَهُ مِمَّا يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they overcame that army by the permission of Allah. And Dawood killed Goliath. David killed Goliath. And Allah gave Dawood alayhi salam all sorts of things, knowledge, wisdom. It was from this group of people, dear brothers and sisters, that the ulama actually say was the most righteous generation of Bani Israel. When the Prophet ﷺ said they had amongst them muhdathun, people that were spoken to by the angels, inspired towards good. It was from that small group of 313, Dawood alayhi salam rose. These were the righteous ones that learned the lesson of a previous generation. And what did Allah do for them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala softened the iron, subjected to the mountains for them. gave them all sorts of things. Dawood alayhi salam. Someone that Allah loved and someone Allah elevated to and someone Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave prophethood to after that incident. Almost every lesson that can possibly be derived for a people that are subjected to humiliation and oppression can be taken from these few ayat in the Quran. One of the things that is not read into this though is the righteousness of Dawood alayhi salam outside of any type of physical strength in battle. What did the Prophet ﷺ praise about Dawood alayhi salam? Did he praise his slingshot skills? Did he praise Dawood alayhi salam for the kingdom that he would amass? Or did he say that the best siyam, the best fasting is the fasting of David, Dawood alayhi salam? He would fast one day and he would break his fast another day. The best qiyam, the best night prayer is the night prayer of Dawood alayhi salam. That last third of the night, that was the habit of Dawood alayhi salam, to pray the last third of the night that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam praised and prayed so that we also would praise and pray. That's what we take from the Prophets. That's what we take from them. That righteousness infuses victory in every single way possible. That the smallness of means are grown by the great length of tahajjud and dedication and qiyam and siyam. And that is a timeless lesson. And then the impact of that is more than just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala getting you out of your oppression, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making you firmly planted in the earth. There is also another thing that we take from this, that every generation is either its own worst enemy or its own ability by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rise. You cannot discount the hypocrisy, the corruption, the oppression, the things that led to the humiliation of a generation before the elevation of a generation. And every time Allah tells us these stories, Allah tells us to look within. Look within. Every single one of us is a part of the equation. What role do I play in my prayer, in my going forth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that righteousness and that power through righteousness. Not one that is sought for the sake of this world, but that is sought for the elevation and the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the companionship of the Prophet.